anyone ever believe they'd be able to take a picture of a living, breathing dinosaur?
All life has two instinctual impulses that no amount of tinkering or engineering, biological or otherwise, can ever hope to overcome. One, survival. Two, reproduction. With man, you can add a third, domination.
Man? Oh, boy. All right, anyway, you're not wrong, which is even more reason we'll need to research a drug to act as a countermeasure to the dinosaurs breeding.
Well, they've had a free run of the island for a while, so we've got to assume that they've been mating. It would be a recurrence plot.
Which is what, exactly?
Although the world is in a constant state of chaos, certain events can be predicted because they happen repeatedly, regardless of the initial conditions. And an organism trying to perpetuate its DNA would be one of those. Or maybe it's the tropical island paradise setting. You know, works for newlyweds.
You know, it could also be the food.
Yeah, perhaps. But considering what some of the dinosaurs have consumed, let's hope not.
I think we've developed a drug that should inhibit breeding. Dr. Malcolm, can you get a team together to administer it?
Well, a ranger team can shoot them with darts while I watch safely and securely from a distance.
Do these ranger teams ever do ride-alongs?
You know, for you, Finch, I believe they'd make an exception.
Task received. Request acknowledged. Confirmed.
It's happening again, Hammond.
No, I won't allow it.
You may not have that choice, John.
Finch, I need to know. Do you have a report?
It looks like the computer systems are under attack. John, we're being hacked.
Dr. Malcolm is correct. The corrupted code has also affected the power grid.
No, no, no!
Don't say the gates are open.
I won't, but they are.
Protection needs to be our top priority. For the dinosaurs and the staff.
I'm staff, right?
Let's get the power grid back. That should help with staff safety.
And I am staff, obviously.
I've got programmers hardening the code as we speak.
Finch, you'll help us get the personnel secured.
Yes, the personnel. The staff, of which I am unquestionably one.
Setting additional task. Understood. Picking up asset.
Resolved.
We've identified some residual flaws in the park operations software. How they got missed the first time around.
You plugged the holes, though, right?
There's some new counter-espionage software that just needs final testing.
Keep people out of our business. Mr. Hammond would also like to make sure the dinosaurs are secure and comfortable. Well, that shouldn't be a problem.
Right. Shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, that's the most common and least true words spoken at Jurassic Park.
Transporting asset. Transportation complete. En route to collect the asset. Asset transportation underway. Asset has been delivered. Thank you.
I'm satisfied with the latest reports on power security. Now, we can move on to the next great challenge, the dinosaurs. For that, we'll have to journey to the companion island, Isla Sorna. We call it Site B, originally a massive holding pen and secondary research facility for our dinosaurs. Spared no expense.
Didn't want to keep all your eggs in one incubator, huh, John?
Aye, that is certainly one way to look at it.
And another way, John?
It's also about the diversity of the environment.
In other words, you weren't sure they'd survive on Isla Nublar.
Darwin's most famous works were centered on species he studied on the Galapagos Islands. Isolated.
It also has the benefit of keeping our work away from prying eyes.
Yeah, and making potential rescue, like thousands of miles away.
Always the negative with you, Dr. Malcolm. For now, we focus on the job at hand. Cabot.
Yes, sir, Mr. Hammond. So, I think we'll need a new base of operations. Ranger outpost and visitor center, maybe? Would make a good headquarters.
Did you two know about this island?
Of course not. We're in the dark as much as you are, Dr. Malcolm.
Who knows? Maybe it's just our inferior brains that can't cope with chaos.
Well, uncertainty, you know, can be a guiding light. Chaos is about the unexpected, and that's what I'm here for.
Well, I'm here because of the dinosaurs.
And because of the lovely Dr. Sattler, if I'm not mistaken.
That's really not any business of yours.